In this video, I'll show you how to use the resume error handler in Make to continue your scenario seamlessly to prevent data hiccups. Quite honestly, in my opinion, this is the coolest error handler because it has superpowers. Let's dive in and I'll show you how to make your automations bulletproof. If we haven't met yet, my name is Andy O'Neill and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. I do this by offering personalized one-on-one Make co-building Zoom video calls and through my community, the Co-Build Collective. All right, so we're going to jump over into a production scenario of mine, in this case for this video. And what this does is it takes Calendly bookings and it creates all kinds of data, but adds them to my NAC database, the event type, and the details of the person requesting a call. So right down here, I have the resume module and you notice it's green, just like the module here. If you add the resume to this one here, just as a side note, I click resume, it's going to be that maroon color. So it takes on the color of its parent module, which makes it a little easier to identify where it goes. You also know this is an error route because those are circles with an outline, but no fill in them. So that makes this an error handler route. How does this work? Well, I sometimes ask for phone numbers from people booking calls with me, and sometimes I don't. And so what happens when I use this phone number module is if I put nothing in there, so if I right click and run this and I don't put any number in there, it's going to throw an error and it's going to stop this scenario and keep it from continuing. So what I've done is I've used a resume module, and this is so cool because I can give the resume module different data and say, if the phone number has an error, use this data instead and keep going. And so what I've done here, if I simply just put zeros in for the phone numbers, so I put zeros here and zeros here, that's all that's needed. And when this hits an error, it goes down here and it grabs those zeros. So I'm replacing the missing data and it continues running the scenario. So for those people that don't have phone numbers, when I look in the phone number field in NAC, my database, it's just all zeros. And I know they didn't have a phone number requirement when they booked a call with me. Let me show you another use case here. Let's say I've got this module right here, this NAC module. And if it has an error, I can search somewhere else to get that data and then give it to my resume. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to do add the error handler and I'm going to do resume. Next, I'm going to right click here and I'm going to add a module. Okay. So I'm going to look for NAC and I'm going to do search for a record. So if this hits an error, it's going to go down here and it's going to search for a record. And then in my resume, I'm going to map the data here that is meant for this module. So if I can find the data somewhere else, or if I can replace the data somewhere else, then I can map it here, and then the scenario will resume using this data instead of the data it was supposed to get from this module. If you want to learn more about a specific Make error handler, check out this playlist. You can subscribe to my channel here. I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.